they are rejecting the teachings of God, and they are not willing to turn their hearts and come to this new relationship to the Father, which will ultimately be through the blood of Jesus Christ. The uniqueness of being one first chosen people of God was now going to be watered down so that all the people of the world could be in relationship with Him. And so Jesus, in many different parables, begins to talk about those who have been particularly chosen and have found themselves or proven themselves unworthy by their actions, and therefore it is being opened up to others. In today's particular epistle, there is a wedding or a banquet that's been planned, and then the master of the banquet sends out the servants to bring the guests, and now all of a sudden the people who said they were coming and they were part of the party have excuses. I have to go check out my
servants who are going out and inviting others as well. There's still
being a member of the body of Christ, and coming and worshiping and receiving the sacrament and hearing the word of God, and being encouraged by being with the other people who also love Jesus. I said this at 8 o'clock service, and I got a lot of good head nod. When these pews are twice as full, there's a pause. Right? When you turn and look and see people near you, there's a nice sense about that. When you're not here, your absence diminishes. And so you're not just here for you, but you're here for the others. And you're here for the next person who walks in that door trying to figure out who this Jesus Christ fellow is and where they fit in his master plan. That's the person you're also here for. This church exists for those who are not yet members of the body of Christ, and we need to be here to welcome and to incorporate. Your physical presence is a great start for that incorporation. So there it is. Thank God you're here today, and I hope and pray if you're not out of town, you'll be here next week, and the week after, and 6 weeks from now. And while you're at it, go out there and invite the halt and the name and your next door neighbor and the person who wants to call at 9 and you can wait till 1. And compel them to Jesus. Because what's happening right here, what will happen at the altar in a few minutes in the consecration of the Blessed Sacrament, and our worship is the most Christ is present right now, and we are worshiping Him. There is nothing more important happening in the world. So let's do it, let's be changed by it, let's be strengthened by it, and let's invite others into it. We have room.